Shambhunath Group of Institutions, shaping the future.
Just like as a voltage transformation equation, we can also counterpart, the value of IA0 equal to 1 by 3 IA, IB, IC. Put these values in this. So we get, VA0 is equal to this whole value here, that is ZF into IA0. Similarly, we can also calculate the value of VA1 and VA2. So we get the value of VA0, VA1, VA2. VA1 is equal to 1 by 3 ZF into IA plus alpha ZF into IB plus alpha square ZF into IC. Taking the value of ZF common, 1 by 3 IA alpha IB plus alpha square IC and this is the value of VA1. Similarly, we know that again IA1 is equal to 1 by 3 IA plus alpha IB plus alpha square IC. Put this value here. So we get VA1 is equal to IA1 into Z. Similarly, we can also find out the value of VA2. We can also find value of VA2 equal to IA2 Z. These are the different voltages values which are coming from the transformer. Now, the next step we have to calculate the sequence voltages. Three-phase balance voltage. VA1 is equal to VA1 minus IA1 ZA1. VA2 is equal to minus IA2 ZA2. And VA0 is equal to minus IA0 ZA0. What the value we are getting from the transformation? The values are VA0, VA1 and VA2. Now put these values in here, VA1, VA2, VA0, where we get the value of IA1, IA2 and IA0, known as sequence component value of current. Now putting the value of V1 first. Value of VA1. Now VA1 is equal to IA1, ZA1 is equal to EA1 minus IA1 ZA. Here we get the value of IA1 by Z1 is equal to VA1 and IA1 is equal to ZF plus ZA1 is equal to EA1 and the value of IA1 is equal to EA upon ZF plus ZA1. The value of IA1 is equal to EA upon ZF plus ZA1. The value of EA1 is also known as the pre-fault voltage. We can also write this equation in terms of VF, that is IA1 is equal to VF upon ZF plus ZA1. Sometimes in the vehicle problem, the value of pre-fault voltage is not given, then we have to assume it is the 1 ampere per unit voltage, that known as the pre-fault voltage. Similarly, we can also calculate the value of IA2 and IA0 with the help of this equation and sequence voltage equation. Now, again, VA2 is equal to minus of IA2 and ZA2. This is also equal to the value of VA2 is equal to IA2 ZF. Here we see that the value of IA2 is equal to 0. IA2 is equal to 0. Similarly, VA 0 is equal to minus of IA0 ZA0, which is also equal to minus of IA0 ZF. Here IA0 is also 0. From these two current equations, we see that only positive sequence value of current is exist in three phase fault, and negative and zero sequence component current value is 0 in case of three phase fault. So if we draw the sequence impedance of these types of fault, we can existence value of it your only positive sequence component current. Now finally we draw the sequence. Finally we draw the sequence network. In sequence network we can show only the positive sequence voltage. Like this. This is your ZA1. This is your ZF. This is your voltage known as EA1, and the value is your current. And the voltage you convert, calculate the value of current IA equal to EA upon ZF upon plus Z1. Okay, now to next problem we can discuss about the problem of the numerical problem in the power system analysis of three phase fault. Okay, thank you.
Shambhunath Group of Institutions, a mentor for glorious transformations.